Good morning, my dear children. Welcome to maths class. Now everyone open page number 57 in studio. So in the last class we completed already 40. So now observe 4.6. It's pep activity. Anjali is hopping from one tile to the other. She has started hopping from the white tile and has taken 3 hopes to be on the grey tile. Okay, she is hoping from the white tile. So here, this is the white tile now. She is hopping 3 times. 1, 2, 3. So now she is in grey tile. Draw cover lines to show where Anjali will be 5 more hopes. Okay, here you have to draw cover lines where Anjali will be after 5 hopes. Okay, children, you have to draw cover like this. So now she is in grey tile. Now it is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So now after 5 hopes she is in white tile. Start counting forward from 3 to find the total number of hopes jumped by Anjali. You have to count total how many hopes jumped by Anjali. Okay, everyone count, children. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Totally, the number of hopes made by Anjali is 8 hopes. Okay, you have to write number 8 in the blank. To add 2 numbers, we start from one of the numbers and count forward to get the total. If we add 2 numbers, first we add the first number and count forward the total. Next, Anjali buys, page number 58. Anjali buys 6 bangles from one shop and 2 bangles from another. So total bangles, first she bought how many bangles? First, 6 bangles in one shop and 2 bangles in one shop. So 6 plus 2, 6 after 7, 8. So total how many bangles bought by Anjali? 8. Okay, note down everyone. Next, 4.8. Anjali wants 6 toffees. Join any 2 plates with a line to get 6 toffees. Remember, you cannot join more than 2 plates. Okay, Anjali wants 6 toffees. Here you have to join 2 plates to get the total of 6 only. Okay, you have to join any 2 plates to get only 6 toffees. So you have to check. For example, if you join here, how many chocolates? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So you have to join these 2 to get 6 chocolates. Yes or no, children? If we join these 2 plates to get the total 6 chocolates, 6 toffees only. Otherwise, here given another one also, you have to check. But you have to join any 2 plates with total number of toffees is 6 only. First, if we join this means don't need to join another one. So if it is not joined, you have to go to the next one. So 1, 2, 3, 4. Here 4 chocolates and here 2. 4 plus 2 is 6. Now you have to draw these 2 plates also. Or otherwise you have to draw 3 chocolates also to get the total number of 6. Different pairs of plates can be joined to get 6 toffees. In the same way, we can get any number by adding different pairs of numbers. Okay, so here 6, actually total 6 toffees. 6, how can we add 6? 3 toffees is also 6 toffees, and 5 toffees plus 1 toffee is also 6 chocolates. So what do you observe here? If we add 2, we can get any number by adding different pairs of numbers. So here 3 plus 3 is 1 pair and 5 plus 1 is 1 pair. If we add the 2 different pairs to get the same number also. Okay, children, next open page number 64.10. The chairs and tables in the classroom are mixed up. Draw lines to match these chairs with their table. The numbers on the chairs should be add up to the number on the total. So here in on the tables given numbers and the chair given in, and in chairs given the two addition of two numbers. Okay, children. On the tables given one number and on the charts given the sum of two numbers. You have to check and add up to the number on the table. So first we are in the first table given number 8 and in the second table given number 9. So you have to check which two numbers is added to get number 8 first. 6 plus 2 is 8. So you have to match 6 plus 2 to the 8. 4 plus 5. So if we add 4 and 5, 4 after 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So 4 plus 5 is 9 means you have to add this, you have to match this chart to this table. Okay. Next, 1 plus 8 is also 9. You have to add this chart to this table. 7 plus 2 is also 9. Now you have to add like this. Next, 4 plus 4 is 8. So you have to match 4 plus 4 to the 8 table. 3 plus 6, 9. And 1 plus 7 is 8. Okay. You have to match the chairs to the tables. Tina and Maya are drawing balloons in their notebook. 4.11. Okay. In here 4.9 is there. Now this is hands-on activity. No. We will discuss this activity later. Now observe 4.11. Tina and Maya are drawing balloons in their notebook. Tina draw two balloons one face. So first she draw two balloons on one face and five balloons on one face. So now total how many balloons did she draw? 2 plus 5, 7 balloons. So in first face she draw two balloons and in the second face five balloons. Totally 7 balloons. Now first Tina drawn the balloons, now Maya. Maya drew 5 balloons on the one face and 2 balloons on the next face. Maya drawn 5 balloons on the one face and 2 balloons on the next face. Maya has drawn totally 5 plus 2. So total 5 after 6, 7. So she is also drawn 7 balloons. Tina and Maya draw the same number of balloon children. Yes. She drawn 7. Maya drawn 7 balloons and Tina also drawn 7 balloons. So take the yes. Both of them drawn same balloons. So the total number is the same. Let us fill the blanks to see if the thing happens while adding two other numbers. Okay. Next, shall we go to the next one? 3 plus 4 is equal to dash and 4 plus 3 is equal to dash. So 3 plus 4, 3 put together with 4, 3 after 4, 5, 6, 7. Next, 4 plus 3. So 4 after 5, 6, 7. So here once you have to check children, 3 plus 4 is equal to 7 and 4 plus 3 also 7. What do you observe here? The total does not change by changing the order of numbers. So once you have to check this order. Here first added 3 and 4. Here first added 4 and 3. Here just change the order of numbers. 3 plus 4 and 4 plus 3. Here the numbers are same. But just change the order of the numbers. So if we change the order of numbers but total doesn't change. Okay, total does not change. So here in this blank you have to write 7 and 7. One more example. 2 plus 3 is equal to 5. And 3 plus 2 is also 5. If we change the order of numbers, but the total does not change. Okay, children. Next, 4.12. 4.12. 2 plus 7 is equal to dash. 3 plus 1 is equal to dash. 4 plus 2 is equal to dash. So here we made cups and saucers. Cups and saucers are mixed. 1 plus 3, 2 plus 4, 7 plus 2. The cups and saucers are mixed up. Add the numbers near the cups and saucer to find the pairs with the same total. First you have to find the total. 2 plus 7, 9, 3 plus 1, 4, 4 plus 2, 6, next 1 plus 3, 4, 2 plus 4, 6, and 7 plus 2, 9. Okay children, 7 plus 2, 9. Now you have to match the cups to the saucers. 2 plus 7, 9. Where do you have the correct answer? 2 plus 7 and 7 plus 2. Here just change the order, but total doesn't change. 1 plus 3, 3 plus 1. 2 plus 4, 4 plus 2. Okay? You have to match like this, children. Next, everyone open companion page number 39. Anjali wants to send a letter to her aunt in another city. She has many stamps with her. Okay, Anjali wants to send letter to her auntie. The letter will reach only when there are stamps adding to a cost of 7 rupees. Okay, the letter will reach only when the stamps are adding to cost of 7 rupees. Circle the stamps which can be used to add up to 7 rupees. Compare your answer with your friends. Okay, here you have to check which of the stamps are added to get the rupees of 7. Okay, on the stamps given rupees. Here which of the stamps are added to get 7 rupees. Okay children, so first here given 7 rupees. You have to take this one also R. And next here given 4 rupees, 5 rupees, 3 rupees, 1 rupee, 6 rupees and 2 rupees. Okay, here what you have to do? You have to add any stamps to get the total 7 rupees. Okay, now I will take 2 stamps here. The first here given 5 stamp, 4 rupee stamp. So first here I am taking 4 rupee stamp. In 7, 4 is, and now you have to check another one, which one of the stamp added to 4 to get 7 rupees. Here already I taken 4 rupee stamp. So 4 of each one is added to the 4 to get 7 rupees. So we are given 3 rupee stamp. So 4 rupees and 3 rupees. If you put together 4 rupees with 3 rupees to get 7, that means you have to take these two stamps to get 7 rupees. Otherwise you have to check remaining also. You have to take remaining stamps also to get 7 rupees. Okay children, so this is about today's class. In project time we are given, collect not more than 7 cloths in your house for laundry. Sort them groups into 3 groups. Count and record them in the space below. Add them to find the total number of cloths. Yes, we are giving our cloths to laundry. Yes or no children? Yes, we are giving like saris, dresses, shirts and uniforms like thing. No, so here asking you have to collect not more than 9. Means you have to take any 9 cloths and group the objects like shirts 3, saris 4 and frocks 2. You have to collect like that. So here already given shirts. Now you have to take any shirts and observe how many shirts are giving for laundry. You have to write here, and saris write number here, and the total class not more than 9 means you have to take less than 9, like 7 cloths or 8 cloths or 5 cloths or 4 cloths. You have to record it and write the numbers here. Okay children, this is your project. Thank you children, this is about today's class. Thank you.